The annual release of data by the Census Bureau includes numbers like the official poverty rate to help us estimate how many Americans are living in poverty. Statistics like the poverty rate give us crucial information on who is struggling in America and what to do about it. But lately, we've seen a lot of conflicting data with huge differences in how we interpret poverty. We know that these measures individually are less than perfect, so how can we get an accurate picture of hardship? According to University of Michigan professor and poverty expert Luke Shaefer, the answer is more data. He notes that if we look across a range of factors, including the poverty numbers released by the census today, we get a better sense of the trends. Data from the Department of Agriculture that chart food insecurity, the official poverty measure, and supplemental poverty measure, for example, follow a similar path. Taken together, these numbers paint a consistent picture of gains in the last several years. But according to Professor Shaefer and others, we know that significant challenges remain. Shaefer says we've made real progress on poverty, to be sure. But after reviewing the trends of the poverty numbers from the census and similar measures, we know that the number of Americans who experience disadvantage or scarcity is significant when we look across this spectrum. He notes that there's no doubt we are experiencing a strong economy. In times like this, we are well positioned to implement programs like those that connect people to jobs, affordable housing, better health, and education to make sure everyone is benefiting.